Here's your host, Alex Garrett.
Well, we are well past 6 p.m., but that doesn't mean we can't have a few minutes of a fix at 6. And boy, do we have a lot to talk about on the One Leg Up feature tonight. Obviously, we've been following the Kansas City fans' deaths, and the toxicology report came out today. And you know what it found? Drugs in the three men that were frozen to death, which means suspicions of the family members accusing Jordan Willis of doing something nefarious could be right. Especially when you see that they had injected fentanyl. Who provided those three men, beyond being Chiefs fans, those three people with fentanyl? And if indeed the man who's now checked into rehab because of all this, Jordan Willis, gave his friends, is that how you treat a friend? Fentanyl. There's a huge problem here. There is legal stature here to really sue Jordan Willis. The 48 hours sleeping is BS. That's a BS defense as far as I could tell. Especially now that well-awaited, well-anticipated toxicology report came out today and showed that, yes, these three men had been drugged. And you could say cocaine, okay, well, whatever, you know, that's horrible. But when you see fentanyl on the list of drugs that were taken, you think three guys that are trying to enjoy a game want to take fentanyl? They had to have been laced with fentanyl. And so, if, you know, there's no doubt that these three men were supplied laced drugs. And being that it was only Jordan Willis's home, that's got to be enough of a reason to say, hey, you know what? That's probably Jordan Willis's doing. And how he got his hands on fentanyl might explain why he's in rehab. He might be a drug user, after all. And to include his friends, is that what you do to a friend? Pretty cowardly. Pretty dastardly. And now the push for justice should be on even more. Even more for the families well before kickoff of the Super Bowl in Las Vegas. I do credit Chris Cuomo for staying on this. I credit the New York Post for reporting on this because not many others are, I feel like. So if there's a few that are trying to get justice for these frozen to death fans, just a few voices can travel a lot, can carry a lot. Kansas City's police department better wake up. And let me tell you, speaking of police departments, I do believe here in New York, the New York City Police Department, the officers that were attacked by migrants that were vicious, criminal, anarchist, the police department of New York, the hardworking men and women in blue, were railroaded by their own Manhattan DA. Because now I find out, here on The Fix at 6 or the 6 o'clock hour, that these animals that attacked two NYPD officers in Times Square cannot even be arrested because they were freed without bail. That is what's being reported tonight. Are you proud, Upper East Side, Upper West Side, for electing Manhattan DA Bragg, who's been letting these criminals off the hook? Are you proud, anybody who said, yeah, we should be an open border country, we should allow everybody in, we shouldn't hold back, it's terrible to build a wall, how you know, racist it is to build a wall. Are you proud now that these assailants are on the run and may not be able to be arrested? links to the stories below. You who wanted open borders asked for this. And I believe there were moderate people who voted for Biden just because it was getting tiring of Trump that still want to close borders and are disappointed. I think for many people, the Biden administration has been a disappointing one. A very disappointing one. And are you proud, DOJ, for intervening in what Texas is trying to do to protect our homeland? Are you proud, Merrick Garland? Because you shouldn't be. And you're getting what you asked for, which is, we don't want any razor wire. We don't want any blockage or blockade of the border. We're just filing anybody in. And now, after the attacks in Times Square, I still believe some won't learn from it. Some won't try and understand it. Some will find it pretty phobic of some sorts, that we don't want dangerous migrants here, dangerous illegal migrants here. We don't. Oh yeah, I've got a lot to unleash tonight on the Fix It 6 at One Leg Up with Alex Garrett, because it's too much. Up until today, it was too much to understand how and why they decided to not attack those responsible for killing our soldiers. Up until tonight, when they bombed in airstrikes portions of Iraq, Iranian-backed bases. But up until that point, I thought the Biden administration was utilizing the excuse that the Americans made a mistake instead of holding Iran accountable for the killing of our troops. Tonight somewhat changes that, but it doesn't entirely change it, because they waited 5 days before they did anything. 5 days. 5 days of anguish for the families who had to deal with Biden calling them. I mean, do you really want President Biden to make calls to families of slain soldiers who have given their lives to America, for America? Not really. Not really. But I do want to end this little fix in the 6 o'clock hour with some good thoughts, some good vibes. This week has given me a confidence to have one leg up in my own life. And I think that is so much more important sometimes than trying to interview those who have one leg up in their lives. Because when we look introspectively and we look to have one leg up in our own lives, yeah, hearing other stories is inspiring. But I hope this podcast inspires you like it inspires me to have one leg up in our own lives and to work for that leg up every day. No matter how difficult, no matter how challenging, no matter how impatient it could be, we can all have one leg up on our own lives. If listening to those interviews I do is encouraging, great. But I do believe, with this podcast, I've been realizing I have to find it within myself to have one leg up on life. When I feel those moments of being in a four-wall setting, unable to see the outside world. But this week, crossing the T's, I have felt that outside world is open, maybe open for business down the road, but open to opportunity, because I decided, you know what? I will go out and have my own leg up. And that's the most important leg up we can have. I love hearing stories of everybody who has their own leg up in their own lives. But I think introspectively, when we have our own leg up in our own lives, doesn't that make you feel better? So that's the good news tonight on a Friday, is I finally realized this brand is supposed to also encourage myself to have one leg up on life. Like I encourage you to. Like I encourage you to have every day I turn on this microphone on Spreaker or whatever platform you may be listening to. And once again, thanks for listening to the Alex Garrett Podcast Network.